أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم The one who is live streaming and the one who is in Masjid I ask Allah bless all of you and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us all of our own good deeds Ya Rabbal Alameen Still with the topic of the fear And the last time I said the word fear mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem, it's Arabic khawf, kha, waw, and fa. Mentioned Quran al-Kareem 145 times. And fear is three different types. One is completely good, related to Tawheed, related to the fear of Allah, related to the fear from the punishment of Allah. And this is, if your heart full of it, you will be inshaAllah, you will be safe, you will be do good, it will wish you to do good and prevent you from doing any wrong, committing any wrong. And if you study the seerah of the Sahaba, companions of Rasulullah ﷺ, you'll find a lot of them who's having it. And Umar ibn Abdul Aziz also, it was very famous about him that he feared Allah too much or that he was doing very good. Umar ibn al-Khattab, as I told you after the Salah himself, was very famous about him that he feared Allah and he cried with the tears out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which this fear will push you to do good, prevent you from doing any haram or wrong. At the same time, Sayyidina Umar used to say, Wallahi law nada munadim min as-sama' أن كل الناس بلا استثناء داخلين الجنة إلا واحدا لظننت أنه أنا هو He said by Allah If there is a call from the sky That all the Muslim Ummah completely Will go to الجنة and they are saved except only one He said I will think that this one will be me About Sayyidina Umar himself And this is out of the fear Fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala And out of also That they did not Think what they did is more than enough. No. They usually do. And they are in between two. As I told you the last time, mu'min in between two. Al-khawfu wal-raja. Fear of Allah and hope of His forgiveness. Fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and hope of the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that this kind of tab, and I'll go on with it, little bit explanation, of the fear of Allah is the best one. Opposite of that completely is a shirky one. When you fear the people, when you fear the jinn, when you fear shayateen, when you fear the sorcerers, when you fear the black magic people, when you fear also يعني, anything related to that, because you should not fear except Allah Azza wa Jal, because you know all of your matter in hand of Allah alone. For that one is good, is fear of Allah. One is bad, the shirky one, is the fear of the people, or fear the jinn, or shayateen, or the sorcerers. One is normal and natural. It's not good, but it's not bad. Which it is the natural one. When you see a snake, when you see the lion, usually you fear. When you see something suddenly, usually you have this fear. And Allah mentioned it about the messenger. I will bring some ayat about it in Quran al-Kareem. But this fear, it will be not bad and not good. No problem with it, because it is something natural new. But it will be with the bad if it prevents you from doing any good. Or if it also encourages you to do wrong. Suppose fear of something, then you start worshipping it. Or you start doing what Allah forbid you to do. Or this fear make you not to do what Allah ordered you to do, then it will be belong to the shirky one. For that it is a three type of the fear. One is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fear of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will lead you to Jannah out of, will prevent you from doing any wrong and will encourage you to do every good. opposite of it, the shirki, one fear of the people, which should not have it. And I'll explain with the details, inshallah. The one in between, the natural one, as long as you keep it as it is, and you try to save yourself from the thing you fear, but without leading you to worship that thing, then there is no problem with it at all. Let us go with some of ahadith. I already explained the ayat the last time. Go back to the last halaqah, you'll find a lot of ayat in Quran al-Kareem. But in Abu Dawood 4755, عن عائشة رضي الله عنها أنها ذكرت النار. She remember about the hell fire, then she cried. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم see her crying, he said, يا عائشة, why are you crying? She said, I remember the hell fire and I remember the punishment in it and how bad is it. For that I cried. Then she asked the Rasulullah, فَهَلْ تَذْكُرُونَ أَهْلِيكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ? With this at the day of Qiyamah, will you remember your families? In the day of judgment, out of, she knows that there is a fear. Will you remember your family? فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَمَّا فِي ثَلَاثَةِ مَوَاطٍ فَلَا يَذْكُرُ أَحَدٌ أَحَدًا. In three positions, three situations, nobody will remember anybody else. عند الميزاني, at the time of the mizan, hatta ya'lam ayakhiffu mizanuhu am yathqal. At the time of the mizan, you will have that fear. Because you don't know your mizan, the balance of it will be heavy or will be light. Until you know which one of it, then at that time, you will never remember nobody else. وعند الكتاب حتى يقال كما في سورة الحق هاؤم اقرأوا كتابية حتى يعلم أين يقع كتابه أفي يمينه أم في شماله أم من وراء ظهره. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said also at that time nobody will remember nobody else. Time of the book, book of record, because everyone have a book of record. And until he say, look to my book of record, I have a lot of good deeds. Until he know, will he receive his book in his right hand? And ask Allah to make all of us receiving our own book of record by our right hand. Because when you receive it by your right hand, means you did good. And it is good written in it. And majority of it is okay. Or by the left hand, ask Allah save us, or from behind him. At that time, he will never remember nobody. Also at the time of the Sirat, the bridge over the Jahannam, nobody will remember nobody. Out of fear. حتى إذا وضع بين ظهري جهنم. In the Sirat, إذا وضع بين ظهري جهنم. At the time of Sirat, when he passed, and this Sirat or this bridge will be in the middle of Jahannam. At that time, nobody will remember. For that Rasulullah say, three position, nobody will remember nobody. At the time of the Mizan, the balance for your good deeds and bad deeds. Time of the book, when will be fly and you will receive it, either by right hand or by left or behind you. Time of the bridge over Jahannam. In al-Bukhari, hadith number 6561 and 6562 and Muslim 2013, wal-lafzu lah, عن النعمان بن بشير قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أهون أهل النار عذابا من له نعلان وشراكان. شراكان, سيور النعل التي على ظهر القدم. شراكان من نار يغلي منهما دماغه كما يغلي المرجل. ما يرى هذا الرجل أن أحدا أشد منه عذابا. يقول رسول الله والله إنه لأهونهم عذابا. Look to this also, and you should fear a situation like that, fear of being punished in Jahannam. That Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, the least one, the minimum one, the one at the bottom, have nobody less than him in Jahannam. Is the one who have shoes. And these shoes, do you know the slipper we use in bathroom, having in the middle some two strip over it? Like that, Rasulullah described me exactly like this. Have something at the end, in the bottom, and these two things. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, but it is this part from Jahannam. He said, all of his body boiling, including his brain. Boiling. Do you know Rasulullah explained? كَمَا يَغْلِي الْمِرْجَلُ. You know, if you bring a container and putting the water in it, and the water boiling inside the container because of the fire under it, this is the example Rasulullah gave. He said, all of his body will be boiling, including his brain. And that man, he will think that nobody have more azab than him. Nobody have more punishment than him. This is the highest punishment. Rasulullah SAW say, and he is the least one. No one less than him. He's very minimum. There is bigger than him. And there is higher in punishment than him. We ask Allah by his great name, save us from that. All kind of punishment. In Ibn Majah, 4268, Sahaha al-Imam al-Albani. An Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْمَيِّتَ يَصِيرُ إِلَى الْقَبْرِ. When we put the dead person inside his grave, فَيَجْلِسُ الرَّجُلُ الصَّالِحُ فِي قَبْرِهِ غَيْرَ فَزِعٍ وَلَا مَشْعُوفٍ. The good person, the righteous one, angel will make him to sit in his grave. He will not fear. Because my talk about the fear, he have no fear because he did a lot of good deeds. And he will not be frightened. Mash'uf, coming out of frightening. He'll be not scared, not terrified. ثم يقال له فيما كنت أي في أي دين كنت. You will be asked the first question, and you have that before. The three questions you will be asked in your grave. And it does not depend upon that, do you know the answer or not? No. It depends upon your good deeds or bad deeds. Your answer will depend upon not did you study it or not. No. Did you do according to it or not? Number one, what's your religion? The mu'min will say my religion is Islam. Number two, who is the messenger come to you? Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Who is your Lord? Allah Azza wa Jalla. For that the mu'min will answer, my Lord is Allah, my religion is Islam, my messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did the message. But the one who doesn't know, the munafiq, the hypocrite, the one who does not do any, no prayer, no salah, no zakah, no siyam, no fear of Allah. This is the part I am in. This one, the angel will ask him, he will say, I don't know. I used to do and I used to say what the people saying in the worldly life. I don't know. In the other hadith, they will say, فَلَا دَرَيْتَ وَلَا تَلَيْتْ. You will never know and you will live and you will be in azab. Then going on in the same hadith here. The mu'min in this hadith, he will say, رَجُلُ الصَّالِحِ, the righteous, the one who fear Allah Azza wa Jal, the one who tried to do all kind of good and save himself and save others from any kind of evil. He will say, my religion is Islam and I was Muslim. فَيُقَالُ لَهُ مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلِ. What about the man he came to you? وَيَقُولُونَهَا بِصِيغَةٍ لَيْسَتْ بِالتَّعْظِيمِ وَلَا بِالتَّحْقِيرِ. They will say it in a way, does not praising Rasulullah and does not put him down. Just a question to you to test as a test for you in your grave. The mu'min, because we're still with the mu'min. يَقُولُ مُحَمَّدٌ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ جَاءَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ فَصَدَّقْنَا. He said, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. He brings to us the truth and clear, plain signs from Allah Azza wa Jal. For that we believed in him, we followed him. فَيَقُولُونَ لَهُ هَلْ رَأَيْتَ اللَّهِ. While you are in a worldly life, did you see Allah? فَيَقُولُوا مَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحْدٍ أَنْ يَرَى اللَّهِ. He said, no, I did not see him. For us also, did you see Muhammad Rasulullah? No, we didn't see him. But we believed in what Allah told us about him in the Quran al-Kareem. We believed in what Allah told us about him through the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَيُفْرَجُ لَهُ فُرْجَةً قِبَلَ النَّارِ. Will be open to him a small place or like a door toward Jahannam in his grave to see. فَيَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهَا يُحَطِّمُ بَعْضُهَا بَعْضًا. He will see the Jahannam destroying each other, hellfire and a lot. Temperature so high and you can here in our only worldly life, if the temperature 110, 120, impossible for anybody to stand under the sun, under outside in the sun, 5 minutes, right or wrong? Yeah. Imagine that Jahannam is not like 110, no, billions of degrees. And whoever does not fear Allah, he will never be saved from something like that. Whoever fear Allah and he try to do good, and I'm saying it clearly, this fear will prevent you from, at the same time, this fear should not make you to think bad about Allah. I already explained that the last time. Fear of Allah with the hope of forgiveness of Allah, with the hope of the mercy of Allah will be good. But fear of Allah and thinking bad about him, fear of Allah and attacking Allah and attacking Rasulullah completely will never be accepted. When he sees Jahannam, then the angel will say to him, انظر إلى ما وقاك الله. Look to what Allah saved you from. ثم يفرج له قبل الجنة. فَيَنْظُرُ إِلَى زَهْرَتِهَا وَمَا فِيهَا. Then it will be open to him another door to Jannah. And he will look to the good things in Jannah and the beauty of Jannah and the na'im and ni'mat of Allah, the favor of Allah in Jannah, prepared by Allah himself. وَمَا فِيهَا فَيُقَالُ لَهُ هَذَا مَقْعَدُكَ. Will be said to him, this is the place, your place in Jannah. Because this is, we're talking still about in the same hadith of Rasulullah, about the righteous person. He will be happy, he will be no fear, he will answer that I am a Muslim, he will answer that Rasulullah is a messenger of Allah, he will answer that my Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will show him part of the Jahannam, and he will be praising Allah that Allah saved him. And the angel will say to him that Alhamdulillah that Allah saved you from something like that. And يقال له على اليقين كنت وعليه مت وعليه تبعث إن شاء الله. You was in certainty of La ilaha illallah, certainty of Muhammad Rasulullah, certainty of the Islam, certainty of the Iman, certainty of accepting the Shahada right way. And you die with that, and you will be resurrected inshallah with the same. You will be resurrected with the same. In another different narration, when he will see Jahannam, he will feel so happy that Allah saved him from it. When he will see Jannah, he will feel so happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make his bliss in Jannah. وَيُجْلَسُ الرَّجُلُ السُّوءُ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say in the hadith, as said in Ibn Majah and in Sahiha lil-Albani 3443, said the evil man, the bad one, the one who neglect the salah, neglect the zakah, neglect the hajj, neglect, and he is so evil, the people, they try to save themselves from dealing even with this kind of people. He will be set. First thing is, because related to our topic, فَيَجْلِسُ فِي قَبْرِهِ فَزِعًا مَشْعُوفًا. He will be having a lot of fear, because if you don't have the fear in dunya, you will have it in akhirah. But if you have this fear in dunya, you will be saved from it in akhirah. He will be terrorized. He will be having a lot of fear in his heart. The angel will ask him, فِيمَ كُنْتْ. What's your religion? فَيَقُولُ لَا أَدْرِي. What's your religion? I don't know. فَيُقَالُ لَهُ مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلُ. What about the man he came to you with the message? He will say, I heard the people saying something. And I used to say what they say. مُنَافِقْسُ وَلَيَعَذُ بِاللَّهِ. Ask Allah, save us from being like that. Say, Ameen. The munafiqeen. With their tongue, as Rasulullah say, their tongue أحلى من العسل. Their tongue is beautiful, more beautiful and more sweet. More sweeter than the honey. But their heart, وَلَيَعَذُ بِاللَّهِ. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. For that he said, I used to hear the people saying some of the things in dunya, in the world they laugh and used to say. Then the angel, they will say, فَيُفْرَجُ لَهُ قِبَلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَيَنْظُرُ إِلَى زَهْرَتِهَا وَمَا فِيهَا فَيُقَالُ لَهُ إِلَى مَا صَرَفَ اللَّهُ عَنْكَ. Then he will look to, they will open a door for him to the Jannah. And they will say to him, look to what? This is your place, what should be your place in the Jannah, but you will not never have it. In not in this narration, he will feel so deep sorry and sorrow, and it is a way of punishment for him. Imagine that when you see something you love and you like and so good and so beautiful and you lost it because of your bad deeds, because of your action, because of your behavior. Then you will feel so sad about it. This is as a punishment for him that he sees Jannah and he lost it. Then will be open another door for him in Jahannam. يحطم بعضها بعضا, destroying each other in Jahannam, boiling. And they will say to him, this is your place. In the other narration, for the mu'min, they will say to him, when they show him Jahannam, this is woes your place. Allah exchange it for you and give you better than it, part of Jannah. Then his grave will be part of Jannah till the day of resurrection, coming out of the graves. This one, the bad one, the evil one, the one who have a doubt, the one who does not believe in Allah, does not believe in Rasulullah, does not believe in Iman, does not believe in, and he have no fear. No fear of Allah, no fear of the punishment of Allah. Some of the people, they're talking about Allah as if they're talking about somebody who's a human being. Those kind of people, impossible that in their heart, any kind of fear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then this kind of people will say to him, did you see your place in Jannah? You lost it already. Then he will find himself in his grave, part of Jahannam. For that there is a dua of Rasulullah, اللهم اجعل قبورنا روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعلها حفرة من حفر النار. Oh Allah, make our grave part of Jannah and do not make it part of Jahannam. Then the angels will say, this is your place in Jahannam. Your grave will be part of Jahannam. Why? على الشك كنت وعليه مت وعليه تبعث إن شاء الله. He said, you die, you live your life in the worldly life with a doubt. Doubt of the Quran, doubt of the Allah, doubt of Rasulullah, doubt of everything. We said already, avoid doubt and suspicion. Because when you suspect everything, it will be habit to you until it will reach to you step by step, higher and higher. With the Islam, with the Iman, with the Quran, with Allah, with Rasulullah, and going on. For that, better not to doubt. Avoid being suspicion. Because this is a habit in a lot of people nowadays. And it is a disease. They will say to whom you was doubting. You was suspicious. And you was, does not believe in anything. By tongue, yes. But by heart, you do not. No fear in your heart. For that, you die with this way, and then you will be resurrected by the same way. In Sunan al-Tirmidhi, Hadith 2308, and Sunan ibn Majah, 4264, 67. عن هانئ مولى عثمان رضي الله عنهما قال كان عثمان بن عفان إذا وقف على قبر يبكي حتى يبل لحيته. عثمان بن عفان, and we know who is عثمان. And a lot of good deeds. And Rasulullah already explained yesterday when I was talking about the Sahaba. Go back to the halaqa about him. What Allah and what Rasulullah said about him. When he begged for the bi'r ruma, Rasulullah and another, many other narration, that Rasulullah said, مَا ضَرَّ عُثْمَانَ مَا فَعَلَ بَعْدَ الْيَوْمِ. Nothing can harm Uthman. Doesn't matter what he did after the day. And in another narration, go and let him know that he is one of the people of Al-Jannah. He used to stay, and when he stand in any grave, he used to cry with the tears. Until the tears make his beard wet. Means he cry a lot. فَقِيلَ لَهُ تَذْكُرُ الْجَنَّةَ وَالنَّارُ وَلَا تَبْكِي وَتَبْكِي مِنْ هَذَا فَقَالَ إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ إِنَّ الْقَبْرَ أَوَّلُ مَنَازِلُ الْآخِرَةِ. They said to him, when you come at the grave, you cry. Why? He said, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the grave is the first stage, first place, first step of the hereafter. فَإِنْ نَجَى مِنْهُ فَمَا بَعْدُهُ أَيْسَرَ مِنْهُ. If he is saved from it, whatever comes after it, more easier. If we are saved from the punishment in the graveyard, in the grave, whatever comes after it will be much easier. Means it is a glad tidings that Alhamdulillah, the coming is easy. It will be the way to the Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the punishment in the grave and punishment in the dunya and punishment in the akhirah. Say Amin. He said, Rasulullah saying, وَإِن لَمْ يَنْجُ مِنْهُ فَمَا بَعْدُهُ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُ. And if he does not be saved from his grave, whatever coming after it, worst and hardest. Because it is like example. The grave is example. Either part of Al-Jannah, lead to Al-Jannah, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin saved, or Walayazu Billah, part of Jannah, ask Allah save us. Then whatever coming after it of the Hisab and everything will be harder and harder and worse and worse. وقال رسول الله ما رأيت منظرا قط إلا والقبر أفضع منه. رسول الله said, I didn't see any bad or any يعني hard thing except I found the grave harder than it. For that the grave is the first stage. And this is will be the part of Al-Jannah leading to Al-Jannah, inshallah, or paradise, or, وَلَيَزُ بِاللَّهِ part of Jahannam leading to Jahannam. وَفِي التَّخْوِيفِ مِنَ النَّارِ لِبْنِ رَجَبٍ narrated by سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب, he said, لَوْ نَادَى مُنَادٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّكُمْ دَاخِلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ كُلُّكُمْ إِلَّا رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا لَخِفْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَنَهُ. سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب, with the taqwa he have, and with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he have, and with the good deeds he did. If it was a good deed, we know what Rasulullah said about سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه. A lot of ahadith for سيدنا عمر, go to فضائل الصحابة in the chapter of Al-Bukhari. It's in فضائل الصحابة. He mentioned a lot about سيدنا عمر, and also Muslim, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Nasa'i, Ibn Majah, and others. At the same time, سيدنا عمر say, oh people, if there is a call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the sky, saying that all of you will enter Al-Jannah except only one. He said, خِفْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَنَا. He said, I fear that this one will be me. That means what? He does not get arrogant of what the good deeds he did, because he doesn't know if it is accepted or not. He is humble and simple. Because this is the situation of the believer. He do good, but he still also blaming himself that I should do more. I should do better. I should do good. Do you get my point or not clear? That even you do good, it does not make you arrogant. It does not make you think that as some of the people that he owe Allah something. No. No. All of your good deeds, all of it will not be even enough to thank for one hour. One favor from Allah to you. For that doesn't matter what you, and whatever you are doing for your benefit, it's not for the benefit of Allah. We know the hadith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that if the whole creation become all of them so good and have the best of the taqwa, it will never increase the kingdom of Allah in anything. And if all of them become so evil, it will never decrease the kingdom of Allah in anything. That means whatever you do good does not benefit Allah. Whatever you do bad does not harm Allah. It is for you or against you. It is for you or against you. For your benefit in the day of judgment or for your punishment in the day of judgment. Look to Sayyidina Umar. In Fudayl ibn Ayyad, he said, إن خفت الله لم يضرك أحد وإن خفت غير الله لم ينفعك أحد. Very beautiful from Fudayl ibn Ayyad. He said, if you fear Allah, no one can harm you. And if you fear other than Allah, no one can benefit you. Listen to it carefully. Fudayl ibn Ayyad saying to us, one of the biggest of the ulama of Islam, saying, if you fear Allah, no one can harm you. Because you fear Allah and you know everything in hand of Allah alone. For that, nobody leaves the people alone. No one can harm you. And if you fear other than Allah, you fear the people, you fear the shayateen, you fear the sorcerers, you fear the jinn, you fear other than Allah, anything other than Allah, no one can benefit you, even including the one you fear. Of the shayateen or the human being, they will never be able to benefit you. For that, this first kind of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have a lot of benefit. Have a lot of good result. What it is? Number one, you will win the Jannah. And you will be saved from Jahannam. When you fear Allah and you fear the punishment of Allah and you try to do the best and it prevents you from doing any haram, this is, there is no any doubt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His generosity will give you Jannah, save you from Allah. Whoever fear in dunya will be safe from the fear in the akhirah. Whoever does not feel it, does not have it, then he will be so scared at the day of al-faza' al-akbar. One of the names of the day of judgment, al-faza' al-akbar. The greatest fear will be in the day of judgment. Because when you see the punishment in front of your eye, only in the worldly life you hear about it and you should believe in it. But in the hereafter, you will see by your own eye, really. That whoever fear in dunya of Allah and fear of with the right way, not with the wrong way, then he will be saved from the fear in akhirah. This fear also a proof of your iman, a proof of your perfection, a proof of that you have, alhamdulillah, goodness in your heart, that your heart is pure. This fear also will bring the love of Allah in your heart and will bring the obedience of Allah and will bring to you also fear of doing any mistake. You will love that Allah see you always in a good places, see you always in a places of obeying, in al-masajid, in al-hajj, in Mecca, in something good. But if you do not have it and far away from you, you will find yourself always in a bad places, evil places, wrong places. Instead of doing the same thing, using internet as example, for the good, you will use it for bad. Even it is there is a good. But you will avoid it. The good one who will use the good. The bad one who will use the bad. Also this fear, one of the reasons of the happiness in dunya, happiness in the grave, happiness in the akhirah. One of the reasons of it. One of the proof, dalil, of your purity of your heart, of purity of your nafs. This fear also, one of the reasons of the hidayah from Allah to your heart. This fear also will make you far away from committing any sin or any wrong or any major sin or any haram. also will bring to you other than the iman and other than the love of Allah and other than the hidayah from Allah, will bring to you the sincerity to Allah. When you fear Allah, you will be sincerely to Him, because you know that He's watching you. And you don't like to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see you in a haram place, in a wrong place. You will always love Allah to see you in good places, in His houses, masajid, the mosques. For that, one of it also, it will bring the mercy in your heart for the people. This fear of Allah, you will not be hard upon the people out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will bring to you, other than the hidayah and the iman, also husnul khuluq. Will bring husnul khuluq to you, and it will make you to avoid being arrogant. Because you don't know, is your amal accepted or not? Nobody knows it, only Allah Azza wa Jal. For that, this is the khawf al-tawheedi, al-mazkur fi al-ayat, the one mentioned in the ayat, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by avoiding the haram, and by doing all what Allah ordered you to do, and worshipping Allah only and sincerely, and this is what Allah ordered you to do, and this is what Allah will be happy and pleased from you if you do. فَإِذَا أَخْلَصْتَ الْخَوْفَ لِلَّهِ فِي جَمِيعِ الْعِبَادَاتِ أَعْطَاكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَرْجُو وَأَمَّنَكَ مِمَّا تَخَافِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. If you have this fear, and you make it sincerely to Allah Azza wa Jal alone, in all kind of ibadat, ibadat of your heart, ibadat of your eye, ibadat of your body, ibadat of all of your mind, then Allah will give you what you want, which it is al-Jannah, and Allah will save you from all kind of fear in dunya and akhirah. But if you have it and we ask Allah to give it to us, say Ameen. Let us now to move to the second one. I said the first one is the fear of Allah. Opposite of it is the shirky one, fear of people. Let us leave that now. Let us go to for the one small, because the explanation about it is not much. Al-khawf al-tabi'i, in between the fear of Allah and between also the fear of the shirk one of the people, there is a natural one. Natural one. الذي ليس معه عبادة للمخوف ولا ترك واجب بسببه. If you fear from the snake, you fear from the lion, you fear from the tigers, you fear from the poison stuff, anything that you fear from, but without this fear does not lead you to worship it. Does not lead you to worship it. Or does not also prevent you from doing good. Does not push you to do wrong. As long as it is just a fear from something, it is a scaring. Snake or lion or tiger or whatever it is. For that, this thing is, as long as in its limit, there is no problem with it. But if it gets out of its limit and you start almost worshiping it, and all of your action because of the fear of it, and it will be leading you to one time will worshiping it, this will be completely forbidden. But if it is not, this is normal. Allah already, Surah Al-Ma'ad, Surah number 70, ayah 19 until 21, Allah said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا. Verily man was created very impatient. إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا. This is the main point I need. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if any evil touch in him, he will be have some fear, discontented. وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ مَنُوعًا. And regardly when good touches him, إِلَّا الْمُصَلِّينَ. So look to the beautiful of the, and the good result of the salah, except the المصلين, except those who are devoted in their salah. الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَى صَلَاتِهِمْ. The next ayah, الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَى صَلَاتِهِمْ دَائِمُونَ. Those who remain constant in their salah. For that al-khawf al-tabi'i come even to the messengers. Allah talk about Sayyidina Musa, Surah Al-Qasas, Surah number 28, ayah number 21, what Allah said, فَخَرَجَ مِنْهَا خَائِفًا يَتَرَقَّبْ قَالَ رَبِّ نَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. When he get out of Egypt because of Pharaoh and his people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he get out خائف, have some of the fear. But this fear does not make him to worship them, does not prevent him from giving them the message of Allah Azza wa Jal. Does not make him to, يعني, only just the fear. No. For that, خائف أن يتركب, looking about, and he said, oh Allah, look to what he did. Even with the fear, he returned to Allah. Oh Allah, save me from this people. In also same al-Qasas, Surah number 28, ayah number 34, قال إني أخاف أن يكذبون. And Allah ordered him go to Fir'aun and his people. He said, oh my Lord, I fear that they will belie and deny me. He mentions the fear. Also with Fir'aun, Surah al-Shu'ara, Surah 26, ayah 21. فَفَرَرْتُ مِنْكُمْ لَمَّا خِفْتُكُمْ. He said, I ran away from you and fled from you because when I feared you. وقال عن هارون وموسى in Surah طه, verse number 45. قال ربنا إننا نخاف. Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina Harun, when Allah ordered both of them, and by the way, the only messenger asked the messengership to his own brother was Sayyidina Musa. No anyone else asked the messengership, Risala, to any other one, except Sayyidina Musa to his brother Harun. قال أرسله معي. He said, oh Allah, make him to be a messenger with me. For that, when Allah ordered both of them, they said, oh Allah, we fear. For that, they mentioned the fear. And Sayyidina Ibrahim with the angels, Surah Al-Dhariyat, Surah number 51, ayah number 28. فَأَوْجَسَ مِنْهُمْ خِيفَةً خِيفَةً قَالُوا لَا تَخَفْ. Then he conceived some fear of them. They said, fear not, don't fear. For that, here Allah mentioned. But also to overcome this fear, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it clear in Quran al-Kareem that relate yourself to Allah, you will not fear nothing. But if really you depend upon Allah and you trust Allah and your relation with Allah is very strong and you know it, you will never fear anything. Because in Taha 45 and 46, when Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina Harun, they said we fear. What Allah said? قَالَ لَا تَخَافَ إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. Allah said to them, don't fear, I am with you, I hear and I see. For that, if you are with the one who hear and see, should not fear anybody else. Do you get my point? You are related to Allah. Your relation with Allah is very strong. Don't fear anyone else. In Surah Al-Shu'ara 15, قَالَ كَلَّا فَاذْهَبَا بِآيَاتِنَا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ مُسْتَمِعُونَ. He said, go with our ayat to them. I am with you, hearing and see. But at the same time, should you neglect and do not take the reason? No, take the reason. Even sometimes it happened with me myself, the people will think that being cautious and being saving yourself and protecting yourself from the evil of the people will interpret it as a fear. No, as long as you know your heart, but you try to save yourself from the evil of the others, there's no problem to save yourself from the evil of them. Do not put yourself in a destruction way and destroy your own self and bring all kind of problem to yourself and do not save yourself and say, I don't fear. No, this is not. Save yourself and take the reasons of it. There is no problem. Even it will be sometime interpreted as a fear. It was not. This is now the natural one that I explain. First one is fear of Allah, which it is the best. And this is the natural one, as long as it is in its limit, does not make you to worship the thing you fear, there is no problem with it. Then the third one, al-khawf al-shirki. The shirki and the forbidden and the haram, fear. Listen carefully, it is two times. Al-khawf al-sirri li-i'tiqadi. In your heart, fearing of the idol, fearing of the tyrant, fearing of the jinn, of the shayateen, of the sorcerers, of the people who read the cups and all of this. Any evil kind of people, if you fear them and this fear will make you to stop doing good or doing evil or going to worship them, become completely forbidden. Then the second one, which I will explain, in general fear of all people. You should not. Fear Allah only. For that the fear of the sirri li'tiqadi, the one secretly comes to your heart but affect your aqeedah. That these people of the sorcerer or shayateen or jinn can bring some benefit to me or can harm me or bring whatever I like or bring whatever I against me, whatever I don't like, this will be shirk. And Allah mentioned in Quran Kareem that they will try to scare you from them, to scare the people of the Tawheed. Did you know the people of the Awali, Ubad al-Qubur, the worshippers of the graves, Usually they use this kind. They will scare you from those wali. Oh, you will lose your house, you will lose your money, you will lose this and that. You will not lose nothing. And if you scared from them, or have some of the fear in your heart out of that, you have the shirky kind. Should not. Fear Allah Azza wa Jal only and say the truth. Against them. Don't worry except Allah. Don't fear except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned about the mushrikeen. When they try to scare Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make him fear their idol, Allah mentioned it. Zumar, ayah number 36, surah number 39. وَيُخَوِّفُونَكَ بِالَّذِينَ مِن دُونِهِ. They try to frighten you with those whom they worship besides Allah. They try to scare Rasulullah from them. Also عن قوم هود. They try to scare Sayyidina Hud. In surah Hud, surah number 11, verse number 54, they said, إِنَّ قُولُ إِلَّا اَعْتَرَكَ بَعْضُ آلِهَتِنَا بِسُوءٍ قَالَ إِنِّي أُرْشِدُ اللَّهَ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ مِن دُونِهِ فَكِيدُونِي جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ لَا تُنظِرُونَ. They say to Sayyidina Hud that we think and we are sure some of our gods, they already have touched you and seized you with some of the evil. They try to scare him. Whatever happened to you, and whatever sickness happened to you, especially if you are with this wali and this graves and that, and something happened to you, unfortunately at the time, right away, all of those kind of people say, this has happened to you because of that. Because you are against them. If this care increased in your heart, and you start to do good to them, and go worship them as they worship, while they do, and they don't know, and they deny. They do it. I see them myself, not all, but some of them, they do sujood to them, which is forbidden to do that. They slaughter their animal for them by their name, which is completely forbidden to do that because slaughtering the animal is one of the ibadah. And this is what they do not want to accept. And they always attack anybody who attacks that or are talking against that. I said, if this wali himself coming out from his grave, he will deny what you are doing. Because we are not against the wali. Wali, majority of them, Allahu a'lamu bihim. But majority, alhamdulillah, they are very good people. We are not against him himself. Majority of them is very good and very pious and very have more taqwa and very famous people. We are not against them themselves or against what the people doing against them or what the people doing for them of going around them like they're going around the Kaaba and kissing their graves and doing sujood to it. This is completely not acceptable. For that Sayyidina Hud, they said, we, our own God is the one who touched you and seized you with some of the evil and some of the harm you have. He said, Inni ushudullah, Allah is my witness. And you are my witness that I am innocent and free from all of the shirk you have. And you have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you have any plot, do it against me. Do not wait. If you have any evil to do, and if they can do anything, let them do. Also the munafiqeen, they will try to يُحَاوِلُونَ دَبَّ الرُّعْبِ وَالْخَوْفِ بَيْنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The munafiqeen, they will try to put the fear in the heart of the believers. In Al Imran 173, Allah Azza wa Jal said, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Those believers, unto whom the people, the hypocrite, they said, verily the other people have gathered themselves together against you. They try to fear them. They try to scare them. For that they said, فَخْشَوْهُمْ, fear them. Fear them. This is does not decrease their iman, does not make them to fear. And this is what the believer will do. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا, but it only increased their iman. Increased them in iman, in belief, in faith. They do not fear anybody except Allah. And Allah alone, they said, Allah alone is sufficient for us. حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. And he is the best of disposer of all affairs to us. Then Allah said, when they have their iman increased and they depend upon Allah and they trust Allah alone, and they say, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. For that if you have any kind of fear or some people threatening you, say what? حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. It could be with the plural, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Could be also with the singular. Rasulullah said it, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Could be with both. فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. Five things you'll get. تنقلبوا بنعمة grace from Allah وفضل superiority. لم يمسسهم سوء. Never touched by any harm or any evil. Protection from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That when you fear Allah, Allah will save you from any kind of other fear. But if you fear other than Allah, he will never be saved from anything. Not from Allah, not from the people. لم يمسسهم سوء. Never be touched by any evil. واتبعوا رضوان الله and they follow the pleasure of Allah. والله ذو فضل عظيم and Allah have the greatest bounty over them. Then, not only those people and the munafiqeen will scare you. Shaytan will never leave you. And Allah mentioned it in the Quran al-Kareem, in Surah Al-Imran, verse number 175. Go to Al-Imran 175. Allah said, إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَهِ And have more than meaning. يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَهِ قَالَ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah say, this is a shaitan. يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَهِ have more than meaning. One of it is, يُخَوِّفُكُمْ بِأَوْلِيَائِهِ. أو العكس لا يخافه إلا أولياؤه. It have سبحان الله even the same word it have two meaning. It make you to fear his follower, his supporter, supporter of shayateen. Or only those a follower of him they fear him. Follower of shayateen and friend of shayateen from the human being is the one who fear shayateen. For that it could be with the two meaning. And it could be happen with the best way also. The follower of shayateen they fear shayateen. And those followers also, they scare others from the shayateen. But Allah said, do not fear them. And fear Allah alone. If you are a believer, in kuntum mu'mineen. If you are a believer, you'll fear Allah. You'll not fear others than Allah. If you are not a believer. Or if you have fear from others than Allah, then we ask Allah save us from being like that. Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 268. الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. شيطان threatening you with poverty and order you to do all kind of evil. Threatening you with poverty to put fear in your heart. When you try to spend the money في سبيل الله, he will bring the fear in your heart. No. Your kids need it. Your wife need it. She will go for asking for divorce and she will take half of the property. Yeah, he will give her half. And you don't give Allah nothing. Subhanallah. Fear will bring fear always. Oh, they are going to the university and need a lot of money. Do not fear except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Trust Allah azza wa jal. Treasures of all kind in hand of him alone. It's not in your hand. Even you have billions. Who give you this money? Answer me. Allah azza wa jal. Then when you give it to him, you are not doing favor to him, to yourself. To yourself. For that here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Shaitan will threat you always with poverty. That, oh, you will be poor. You will need. You will this. You will that. And he order you to do every evil. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you forgiveness and bounty and mercy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all sufficient for his creature's need. Wasi'un. All sufficient for his creature's need. سبحانه وتعالى عليم all knower know everything. For that ينتج من هذا التخويف الشيطاني خوف العبد خوفا موهوما على نفسه أو ماله أو ولده أو مستقبله أو صحته أو متاعه أو غيره. If the شيطان controlling your heart and put the fear in your heart, it will bring الوهم. Too much fear about your own self, about your own money, about your own kids, about the future of you, about the future of your kids, about your own health, about your own wealth, about everything. You will find a lot of fear. And this fear will come to you all the time and will make you not to rest at all. How you overcome it, and you will stop with that because of the time, you overcome it by one, at least there is one, dhikrullah. Mentioning the name of Allah and make your relation with Allah stronger and stronger and stronger. In Al-A'raf, Surah number 7, ayah number 200. وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ إنه سميع عليم. If there is evil whisper from the shaytan comes against you, then seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, it's the shaytan. Allah is the all hearer, all knower. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us that if there is an evil whisper coming from the shaytan, to do what? Go back to Allah. Mention the name of Allah. In Surah Al-A'raf 201, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ مِّنَ الشَّيْطَانِ تَذَكَّرُوا فَإِذَا هُمْ مُبُصِرُونَ. The believers, when they touched by any kind of evil thought, comes from the shayateen, then they will remember. They will remember what? Allah Azza wa Jal. They will remember the dhikr of Allah. Then they will be in a right way. In الدر المنثور, volume number 8, page number 694, Ibn Abbas, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مِن شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ, I seek refuge in Allah, also with Allah against Shaytan, the devil, the shayateen, the Satan. الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ, قَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ جَاثِمٌ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ ابْنِ آدَمَ فَإِنْ سَهَى وَغَفَلَ وَسْوَسْ وَإِذَا ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَنَاسْ. From the evil of the whisperer, the shayateen, who whisper evil in the heart of the men, and in the ears of you and in your heart, and he will withdraw, and he will stop from this whispering when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, when you remember, he will not whisper to you, he will not scare you, he will not come to your heart, he will not come to your mind. But when shaitan can come to you, when you are far away from Allah, when you do not mention. For that, one of the treatment and the medicine from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, is this kind of fear of shayateen or the jinn or the and this is also related to the black magic. Go back to the halaqa of the black magic, that it will benefit you, that be mentioned the name of Allah always, and be with Allah, Allah will be with you. Be with Allah, Allah will protect you. Be with Allah, Allah will help you, Allah will aid you, Allah will support you, Allah will benefit you, Allah will take out that fear from your heart, otherwise you will destroy yourself. For that is the shaitan whispering to you, then remember Allah. In Surah Al-Ra'd, verse number 28, قال الله عز وجل أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. With the remembrance of Allah, your heart will get rest. Your heart will get tranquility. What about fear of fail? Fail in your job, fail in your business, fail in your life, fail in your PhD, fear in your master degree, fear in your... And all of the akhi, subhanAllah. Most of this fear about the worldly life. Most of this fear. Did you ever see anybody say fear about that I miss the Jum'ah, fear about I miss the Salah and Jama'ah, fear about that I miss the Khatm al-Quran? Very few. There is, alhamdulillah. Khair in my ummah, as Rasulullah said, ummah of Muslim till the day of judgment. But they are not big in number. But majority fear about business, fear about money, fear about wife, fear about house, fear about the car, fear about the many other things related to the worldly life. Ask Allah save. What it is, and inshallah the next time will be some more explanation. And going on with the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with the hadith of Rasulullah, احفظ الله يحفظك. Then we'll move to the second kind of fear, fear of the people. Fear of the people. If it lead you to leave something, order you to do it, Allah order you to do it, or to do something haram, what it will be. Inshallah, in the future, we'll go on with more details. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husna ibadatik. Wa ansurna wa la tansur alayna. Wa a'inna wa la tu'in alayna. Wa ansurna ala man baga alayna. Wa ahdina wa yassir al-huda ilayna. Wa arihna wa afrihna wa asturna wa la tafdahna. Wa yassir lana umurana wa ashrah lana sudurana. Wa aghfir lana dhunubana. Wa kaffir anna sayyatina. Wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى واغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عن من سواك وصلي اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزاكم الله خيرا. And always for the sake of Allah, remember us in the best of your dua, and the angels will do dua the same for you, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.